Okay, hi Traders, hier ist ein Video. First of all, risk warning, your invested capital might be at risk. Don't trade with money you cannot afford to lose. And this video is not investment advice. So this video is another binary option trading, binary options strategy video where I'm going to show you how I have done the trades and based on those kind of concepts which I have explained in the ebook. Get this ebook. Yes, you find the link in the description. This ebook contains the most important candlestick pattern, chart pattern, and binary option tool trading concepts, market condition, trend identification, rejection, and candlestick mass, and a lot of more concepts which can be applied to any kind of time frame, any kind of financial instrument, and any kind of broker. So get this ebook, you'll find the link in the description, and in the description you will find also the link to the Facebook group. So yes, I want to show you those kind of concepts which are the most important one here in this ebook, apart from the candlestick patterns. Yes, so I can recommend to all of you to understand first of all kind of candlestick patterns. Yes, the most common one are the first, then all kind of chart patterns, which are also important to understand for overall this kind of trend channel stuff here. Yes, watch those kind of videos, try to learn those things, apply them to your trading. Yes, because they are the most important one. I will mention not everyone, I will mention also those one which you should care about. So we have here the part about the rejection, which is in general a relation to the four keys. Yes, you see the key level, the trend, and at the end the rejection after the candlestick pattern. Yes, those four things should be all together to get a good trading setup with a probability around 80%. So then the market conditions, yes, which I have explained over and over again: healthy trend, strong trend, and consolidation area. Price action behaves completely different according to the market condition. So you should understand what kind of market you have in front of you to understand what price action is telling you, yes, and what the price is trying, or the market is trying to tell you. Then the EMAs, yes, if you are using EMAs on your chart, you should know what the EMAs are telling you, what is the major trend, what is the minor trend, and how you get those two things together to get a high probability trading setup. So then that is maybe the Three Right Soldiers are wrong here. I have to put them under the candlestick patterns, because those ones are wrong here. So let me get this, the Three White Soldiers and the Three Black Crows should be here. Yes, I put them here in the candlestick pattern stuff at last, the last one, because it's a 3-bar candlestick, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. I put them here where the other 3-bars candlestick patterns are, like the evening star, and so on. Okay, so I have moved this. So yes, then the part about candlestick math. Yes, and I will do much more videos about candlestick math soon. Yes, because I got so many requests of this. The trader need to know how to do this calculation based on candlestick math. I will show you this in one of the next videos when I'm doing again some deep explanation videos. I don't know when, but I will do this because it's important to understand how to calculate all things together. I will maybe do another example today or in this kind of video where I'm going to show you how to calculate them. So, and then we have this part about the four keys. It was again about the rejection, to make you clear that the rejection is only a small part based on a small part on the complete trading setup. Yes, it's the main part should be the analysis here. That is this one here where I have explained how the running candle should move to make it clear what will happen here. As you see, that is a 5-second chart or the line chart. Yes, and then it looks like this. Yes, you see here 80% success. If you get those things together, and if you use my simulator, yes, my win rate simulator, you see, yes, it's loading. Wait, it's loading. I have to stop the video 1 second, and then I load it. So, okay, it was a little bit overloaded here, the computer, yes, because I'm recording, I'm doing this other stuff. So, okay, I lo it loaded here, you see here 80% win ratio, yes, if you have a 80% win ratio and you click here on submit, you will see that you get almost three in the money, yes, it's not the complicated stuff, and if you have only a session of three or four trades, then you can mostly get those three, four in the money. As you see here, one, two, three in the money. Yes, let me do here. You see also with 80% win ratio, you get much more in the money. Yes, and if you will click here often, you see you get almost so many in the money. That means losing a trade or losing streak will be really rare. Yes, because you get them almost in the money. You see here, what that if you do only three wins a day, yes, you have here one day, 2 days, yes, with 80%. And if you're doing this every day, you will nearly never get a loss, yes. But if you are trading too much, then you will obviously facing loss. This is a good example how you can build up your confidence if you are waiting and trading only those kind of opportunities which are based on those kind of setups here. There's the trend, the key level, the candlestick pattern, and the rejection. So fake breakout, almost important topic. I will maybe doing another video about fake breakout soon. Yes, I think also in this kind of video I have a fake breakout here. I will show you this. This is for those one who are seeking or are chasing this kind of fake breakout, they will get bad experience. You should understand when to do this kind of trades, because often it will be a continuation and not a fake breakout, and it's only a question of the anticipation. Yes, okay. So then, obviously, the reversal and retracement stuff. A reversal on minute time frame is a retracement. You see this kind of candle here. Is this what happened here? Yes. So if you understand this, you wait for the signals, for the understanding, for the wicks, which are showing you where the pressure is coming. Then obviously the high probability trading setup stuff. And I show you only those kind of concepts which you should know inside out. Yes, I'm not showing you all the kind of concepts, but those are the concepts which you should know. Yes, inside out. That means you have to have them always in mind. Yes, and apply them to your trading. So then the next are not so much important. The next one are not so much important. I have discussed them also in the previous one where I have shown you. Yes, then we are talking about this one here where I talk, no, this one, not about this one here where I talk about the major support and resistance and the minor support and resistance levels. Here again, yes, that is another topic, how to do the trades. Yes, after you have confirmed that it was a major support and resistance level, then you can enter and trade. Don't trade here where this kind of area is not confirmed, because price can go down further. Yes, those concepts are important. Then also how to distinguish or how to spot support and resistance based on the candlestick patterns. Yes, I have done an example on the last video where I showed you watches, where I showed you where support and resistance are based on this progression, as on the progression of this candlesticks. Yes, you see here, here we have resistance, resistance, resistance. Yes, here we have support, support. Yes, and the same thing here. Here, how you have to do the trades. Yes, that is important. If you understand those kind of concepts, you know that you have to do your trades based on those six things here. Yes, the time frame analysis, trend analysis, market condition analysis, support and resistance analysis, chart pattern analysis, and candlestick pattern analysis. And after this, you enter into a trade. Yes, you have to be patient. Yes, you have to be disciplined, and then you can do a really good high win ratio and get profitable. So, and then obviously those kind of things here where I have explained how it looks like and what kind of candles are mostly sure shots. That candles after this kind of weak candles are mostly sure shots. If you get an evening star and you get such kind of candlestick, then you can predict that the next candle will go down if you have an upper shadow. And the same is valid for the rest. Here, that are those kind of that are those kind of pages which I have done in the seventh edition of the ebook, yes, where I have explained really the important stuff about the running candle, yes, how to predict the direction of the running candle. And obviously this one, which is one of the most ones, where I have explained where you should find your entry point, where should be your entry point, yes. That is the most reason why often traders gonna get out of the money, because they do not enter on the right moment into the trade, or get a wrong or bad entry point. So, and then obviously this page here, which is a tribute to the purchase time and the expiration time, the difference between those and how they how the candle should move. And if you are patient and you see this kind of behavior, then you know. And so with this kind of cheat here, you can get you can increase your success rate dramatically, yes, because you know now the right movement, yes, because market is moving in waves, and if it's going down in the purchase time, it will go up in the expiration time most of the time if there is not a strong trend. So market condition stuff, obviously, yes, it's important. Watch this video, get this get the information here, yes, of the video. Watch this things which I have done, what your kind of condition you should avoid, what not, and then obviously the timing is crucial for success in the trade. Yes, you should know when to trade, and that is mostly London session and New York session. Yes, avoid the other sessions if you are doing 1 minute expiration time trades. If you are doing longer time frame, you can do also your trades on the Asia session. I would not recommend this, because price action is working only on high volume or on good volume. So here we have the kind of stuff which I have explained about the Bollinger Band and the EMAs. Watch those videos, they are important. So, and that we are already, that was all, yes, that was all, which you should know, what you should cover every time, and which you should have in your mind, yes, really, really inside out. Yes, you should name those things blindly, and you should recognize those things also on the chart. So, okay, that was this one. Let's start with the video. And here we have this kind of behavior. You see immediately the alignment of the EMA. We have here a downtrend. We are coming from a ranging market here, consolidation area. We have here Bollinger squeeze, ranging market. Yes, here we got a breakout. And here we see we are going far away from the two deviation Bollinger Band. What does this mean? That means that we are getting here into a reversal. Yes, this area here, let me show you this. This area here between the one deviation upper band, lower one deviation lower band, are the reversal area. That is ranging market. Here we have the downtrend, yes, between the one deviation lower band and the two deviation one, we have a downtrend. And what do we have here? Here, that is nothing else than a nice double bottom, yes. So we can expect that price will most probably continuing to going up, because we have not a really strong downtrend established, because we have here still ranging market, yes. That means that trend is really fresh. And so you can expect that price will reverse from this level and going up here. Yes, that is what I would expect immediately. What also you should see immediately when you see such kind of chart. Yes, if you see such kind of chart, you should understand. Here we have the neckline. Yes, this is the neckline here. And okay, that was already. And as soon as there is a trade, I will stop, and then I will explain what's happening. But I think there will be not so much to explain, because those one who are following already my videos, okay, I entered into a call. Those one who are following my videos do understand that we are trading here nothing else than a double bottom. Yes, this candlestick with the lower shadow showing that we have a huge buying pressure. Yes, we are already 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, almost 10 minutes in a consolidation area. Yes, so it will be time that we're gonna break out of this consolidation area. And because the lower shadow is showing that we have here huge buying pressure, I entered here into a call. call. But important here is, because I did a call, I tried to enter below the previous candle closing price. Here, closing price of the previous candle, I entered below. For the case that we get a small, bearish candle, that this will be still in the money. Yes, that is what I have explained in the ebook, what I have shown you a few minutes ago. Yes, where I showed you that those kind of behaviors, or those kind of choosing of the entry point is crucial. Yes, it's crucial. Sometimes it's not. You are not able to do this. Yes, because of the. Of the market itself, yes, because mostly price will not retrace back below or above the previous candlestick price or opening price. But mostly you have the opportunity and you can increase your odds, yes, and you can increase your win ratio dramatically if you are entering above or below the previous candle closing price. That is almost the best decision to enter into an entry point. So, okay, then here we see I will do a little bit far forward because I have not entered here into a trade. So, and then I entered immediately into a call because this candle here broke the support and resistance level, this kind of neckline here. You see how often the price reversed here, and that was a clear sign for me that price will enter into a trend continuation. Yes, this candle was not so convincing, but this was giving me the rest. That means that was those candle showed me that there is huge buying pressure still active, because if this would have been a bearish candle, I would not enter into a call, to be honest, because then the closing, the consolidation area would have been not over, yes, but because I saw this kind of candle here, which closed above the support and resistance level here, or the neckline of this double bottom, I entered into a call. So that was this one, and then we got here a really nice Marabuto-like candlestick, yes, a shaven head. Yes, the lower shadow is not so important, but the upper shadow is nice, really cutted. Yes, a really nice Marabuto head here. Yes, and that was the reason why I have done here a trend continuation. The level where I entered here into a call was not the best one. I should have been waiting till closing price, lower entry point below the closing price of the previous candle. I didn't have done this because I entered immediately. I don't know why, yes, but I entered immediately, and that was not the best decision in this kind of area, because we are here in between of the 50 EMA and the 20 EMA, and that is almost consolidation area, and at this kind of level, everything could have been happening. Yes, obviously, it's a breakout, yes, of this neckline, and that is obviously a trend continuation. Trade is much more probably, but you see, it was a close one, only a close one, yes, and if I would have entered below the closing price of the previous candle, it would be much safer. I didn't have done this, yes, but anyway, so, and after this, this was now the process of elimination, what is happening now, maybe, because I understood that this will be a fake breakout, yes, because the previous candle was not as strong as I was expecting, yes. The lower shadow of the previous candle was showing me that we have selling pressure instead of buying pressure. The upper shadow is smaller than the lower shadow, yes. The real body is like a doji, indecision completely, and that was the reason why I entered here into a put, expecting that there will be a reversal happening or a retracement. Or better to say, a fake breakout of this support and resistance level. Yes, and that's the reason why I entered into a put. And you see, price got down. So, okay, that was already. That were all kind of trades which I want to explain here. You see how important those kind of concepts are, which I have explained in the ebook. You see here, double top again. Yes, here that was now a complex pullback. And after another few candles upwards, it would get back to this level in the next future. So, okay, that was it. So, if you like this video, do a like. If you didn't subscribe, subscribe to my channel. And if you have something to say, drop me a line in the comment section. So, I would say stay safe and bye-bye.